Would you like to know the outcome of the UEFA Champions League final match between Manchester City and Inter Milan before it even begins? Today, I will answer that question. My name is Illyrial, and I provide match predictions using state-of-the-art artificial intelligence technologies. In my recent videos about the Champions League, I accurately predicted Manchester City's victory over Real Madrid and Inter's win against Milan. In today's overview, I will analyze the team's readiness for the game and make a prediction for the winner. I will also forecast the exact score with which the match will conclude. Please note that my project is non-commercial, and there is no advertising on my channel. If you like my prediction, feel free to support me with a like and subscribe. Let's get started. The final match of the 2022-23 UEFA Champions League will take place on June 10 at the Atatürk Olympic Stadium. Bookmakers unanimously express confidence in the victory of the English team. However, their opinion does not interest me, and as usual, I will conduct a detailed analysis of the indicators using artificial intelligence. Let's start with the historical aspect. Despite Manchester City not being a young club, founded in 1880, it gained widespread recognition only in 2002 after returning to the English Premier League. This was attributed to the Arab injection, and Manchester City was then called the Moneybags. Since then, the citizens have won the National League Championship 6 times. Before that, the team won the English League twice, in 1937 and 1968. Despite these and many other achievements, the club has never achieved the coveted goal of lifting the Champions League trophy. In 2021, the team even reached the English final but narrowly lost to Chelsea. Italian Inter needs no introduction. It is a prestigious team with numerous fans worldwide, possibly even among my subscribers. Inter has won the Italian League Championship 19 times. They have also won the UEFA Champions League/European Cup 3 times in 1964, 1965, and 2010. In addition, the black and blue team has won the UEFA Europa League 3 times in 1991, 1994, and 1998. After Arsenal's defeat, Manchester City became the champions of England ahead of schedule. It should be noted that for a long time, London's Arsenal was leading the league. However, Pep Guardiola's team caught up with their opponents and demonstrated in the head-to-head match that they wanted the championship more, 4-1. Currently, with a game in hand, Manchester City is 7 points ahead of the Gunners and out of reach for their competitors. It is worth noting that Manchester City scores a lot of goals. Currently, the citizens have netted 93 goals against their opponents. Here, the phenomenon of Erling Haaland stands out. The Norwegian is having an incredible season, and he is being talked about and written about by all media outlets. He has already set a record for the most goals scored in a Premier League season, and the tournament is not yet finished. To summarize, Manchester City currently looks like a cohesive unit with a top-class striker leading the line. The team can adapt during matches, maintain high pressure throughout the game, and possesses a high conversion rate and a quality defensive line. The club has conceded 31 goals in the league, which is the best defensive record in the league this year. What about Italy? Napoli secured the championship ahead of schedule, while Inter is fighting for the second spot with Lazio, trailing them by 2 points. It is worth noting that Inter has shown good form in their recent matches. After a loss to Monza, 0-1, they have won 5 consecutive games. For comparison, Manchester City has a streak of 11 consecutive wins in the league. However, in the last round, they lost 3-1 to Napoli away. Internazionale cannot be considered a high-scoring team. In Serie A in general, fewer goals are scored compared to the Premier League. It is difficult to identify a clear leader among the Nerazzurri, but it is worth mentioning their top scorer, Argentine Lautaro Martinez, who recently became a world champion with the Argentine national team. In summary, the team has formed a fairly strong squad for the first time in many years, at least in terms of names: Lukaku, Zeko, Calhanoglu, Mkhitaryan, Martinez, and others. Simone Inzaghi has effectively changed the team's playing style in just 2 years. The team suffers quite a few defeats and often concedes goals first, indicating a lack of football character. In Group C, Inter effectively fought for the second spot with Barcelona. while Bayern Munich won all their matches, Polish side Victoria lost all of theirs. The Italians needed to have successful matches against Barcelona, and they succeeded. They narrowly defeated the Catalan team at home thanks to a goal from Calhanoglu, and they played out an intense draw away, ending 3-3. Despite having all the chances to win, Barcelona scored their third goal in the 90+2 end minute. Manchester City confidently secured the first place in their group without a single defeat. The team played two goalless draws away, against Copenhagen and Dortmund. During the group stage, the club scored 14 goals and conceded only two. Manchester City dominates at home and dismantles Leipzig, who, after their performance in the group stage, 12 points and a victory over Real Madrid, appeared to be a team that could put up a fight. Quarterfinals proved to be challenging for both teams. They both won their first matches, with Inter doing so away from home. The second matches ended in a draw. Bayern Munich gave Manchester City a tough fight in Munich, dominating for the majority of the match, but it only resulted in a scoring draw. There was a lot of talk about the second leg between Inter and Benfica because by that time, it was already known that AC Milan had advanced to the semi-finals. Everyone was anticipating the Milan derby in the semi-finals, and they got it. Inter took control of the game and scored an early goal. By the 80th minute, the team was leading 3-1, although they managed to concede two goals towards the end. Nevertheless, the result satisfied the Italians. As for the semi-finals, while the matchup between Manchester City and Real Madrid can be frequently seen in the Champions League, for example, Real Madrid knocked out City in the previous edition, the Milan derby in the main European tournament is a truly rare event. Real Madrid easily progressed to the quarterfinals, defeating the struggling Chelsea. In the first leg in Madrid, Manchester City played as the team trying to stage a comeback, and after the match, there was a feeling that Real Madrid could stop this team that had gained momentum in their domestic league. However, the second leg set everything straight. There was only one team on the field that day, and it ended 4-0. Milan, on the other hand, had a difficult path to the semi-finals, coming second in their group, defeating Tottenham in the round of 16, and surprisingly eliminating Napoli in the quarterfinals, which many had predicted to win the tournament. But in the Milan derby against Inter, they couldn't offer any resistance and lost both matches without scoring. In the end, the two teams approach the final differently. One is the favorite, expected to claim the title they deserve based on their performances, while the other is considered an underdog. One is chasing a logical title that they should finally win based on their game, while the other seems to have surpassed expectations, but is motivated and capable of performing against a stronger opponent. There are numerous cases where teams can produce a completely unique match that doesn't resemble others. Typically, this occurs when a weak team plays against a giant, but my analysis suggests that this isn't the situation here. Manchester City will win with a score of 2-0, and an intriguing final awaits us. If you would like to hear a prediction for a match of interest to you, please write the participating teams, the date of the match, and the championship in the comments under the video. I will definitely provide a prediction to all my subscribers, and for the most popular matches, I will create a separate video review. Thank you for your attention.